Natasha Files, Minister for Health, and with me I have Deputy Chief Health Officer Dr. Payne. Just to provide an update this Sunday afternoon for Territorians around the COVID-19 situation in the Northern Territory. I do have a little bit of detail today, so I do ask people to bear with me while we go through that. So we have had 4 new cases of COVID-19 recorded in the Northern Territory overnight. 3 of those cases were linked to the current cluster and outbreak that has started in Katherine, and one was the case of a return traveller, and so I'll provide details on that one international arrival. It was a man in his 60s. He traveled into the territory on the Qantas flight London-Darwin, arriving on November the 10th. He is in CNR, and so we understand that he is a low risk to the community from the information that's been gathered. So we wish him all the best in his recovery, and that is the one case that is not linked to the current cluster. So the total case count for our current cluster is now 71, and all 3 of these cluster cases are linked to Katherine East and around that Acacia Drive, where we have been undertaking a testing blitz. There are now 11 cases in that area of Acacia Drive, Katherine East, that have come forward and been found. I'll just run through the details of those new cases. So one is a 4-year-old child who has been in the Centre for National Resilience for their entire infectious period. The child is a family contact from those previous cases in Katherine East. So we wish that little one all the best and hope for a speedy recovery. There's also positive cases in a 15-year-old girl and a 17-year-old girl who we have located during our testing blitz in Katherine East, and they'll now be transferred to Centre for National Resilience. I understand that they're not related, but they are from that cluster and perhaps known to each other. So we've identified quite a significant number of people that we believe are close contacts of these infectious cases to date. We think that there's about 60 household contacts of the previous cases in Acacia Drive and those surrounding streets. So that is a significant number, and we strongly suspect that we'll have more positive cases in the coming days. In fact, we're surprised that we haven't seen more cases to date, but that's a good sign. But Territorians should be prepared for more cases coming out of that Katherine East situation. And we'll make sure that they are cared for appropriately, transferred for Centre for National Resilience, and make sure that they have everything to keep them comfortable and provide them with the best care. As we have said, elimination is not possible. It's not an option for the Northern Territory. But by getting this group out of Katherine into CNR, we can make sure that they are provided the appropriate care and supported, and we can also try and slow that spread of COVID. In terms of testing, we're still seeing significant numbers of Territorians come forward to be tested, which is fantastic. We usually see the weekend where there's less people, but over 2,000 tests were conducted in the Northern Territory in the last 24 hours, 2,038 to be specific. 263 of those were in Katherine and 182 in Alice Springs. So really thank those people in those regional areas for coming forward. And now to wastewater, which is provides us with a lot of information, and certainly the health teams have been meeting this morning with the Territory Controller around understanding, and there's a fair bit of detail in the wastewater. So the good news from the wastewater is that Alice Springs has turned to a presumptive wastewater detection. So that means the reading is weaker, and so it's a good sign. We'll continue to take samples from Alice Springs. It doesn't mean that they're out of the woods yet, but it's a good step forward for Alice Springs. So it could have been someone transiting through. It could be someone shredding that virus. So Alice Springs wastewater has gone presumptive. And because we have the high rates of vaccination, we feel comfortable with the measures in place, but remind anyone, and we did see many people come forward in Alice Springs to be tested, so please do so. We do have positive wastewater through a number of catchments associated with Katherine. Some of this can be explained through the viral shedding, but of people that have returned to the Katherine region, but some of it, we do believe there is COVID in Katherine, and that is of concern to us. So we also have positive wastewater in some of the remote communities surrounding Katherine. And so I'll inform you of those community names and also our response. So we now have positive wastewater in a number of locations in Katherine, and we'll make sure that those are listed on the website and through Secure NT, but that Bicentennial Road, Martin Terrace, there's a number of locations. Binjari and Rockall have gone to no detection, but in terms of communities surrounding Katherine, Buller, Dagaragu, Pigeonhole, Kalkaringi and Larjamanu all have detection of COVID in their wastewater. So that is in addition to Barunga and Beswick that we informed the community of yesterday. So for the communities that have been identified today of Buller, Dagaragu, Pigeonhole, Kalkaringi and Larjamanu, we'll be putting in place a mask mandate for 72 hours for those communities and the surrounding homelands. This measure is to protect the community, so please make sure that you, where you can't physically distance, you put a mask on. We also have, moving a little further south, a detection of positive wastewater in Tennant Creek town area. Now, I must acknowledge that this is a weak reading, and so we could see the situation where it disappears, but it is very concerning to us that we've got a detection in Tennant Creek, and we don't have any positive cases in Tennant Creek that could perhaps explain it. And we've got a low vaccination rate in Tennant Creek, 69% fully vaccinated. So we are putting in place a 72-hour mask mandate for Tennant Creek, and we'll be introducing this for the surrounding homelands and communities. This will take a lot of resources, but it's important. We're also stepping up our vaccination and our testing in Tennant Creek. We've got a great team on the ground in Tennant Creek. We've got Anangining, the local Aboriginal medical organisation provider who work closely with NT Health. The Tennant Creek team will be supported by a rapid response team that's going to head up from Alice Springs, a health team. So there is testing and vaccination available at Tennant Creek Hospital this afternoon, and that will continue. So a really important message for the residents of Tennant Creek. There is wastewater detected, COVID wastewater in the detection, and we really need people to make sure that they're vaccinated. First dose, second dose, and booster doses as appropriate. Please, if you feel any symptoms, get tested. The mask mandate that I've just talked about for all of those communities means that you must wear a mask indoors when you cannot physically distance. They're a very good preventative health measure to stop the spread, so really important, and we ask the community to please cooperate. If we all do cooperate, we're likely to see these measures lift sooner rather than later. And just a final update around the Beswick community. Big shout out to the community of Beswick. They've done a great job. Their health team there, Sunrise, have been working with NT Health, not only NT Health, but our other frontline workers. They've been doing going door to door, getting people to head down to the basketball court to get those all important tests and vaccinations. So just in closing, I'll summarise. Buller, Dagaragu, Pigeonhole, Kalkaringi and Larjamanu and Tennant Creek all have a mask mandate from 2 p.m. today, 2 p.m. Sunday. If you come from a surrounding homeland or community, that also includes you. We'll put that Chief Health Officer direction out shortly so people can clearly understand that. We can't eradicate COVID-19 in the Northern Territory. That's quite clear, but we are surprised at the low case numbers to date. So I must forewarn Territorians that we won't be surprised if we see these numbers increase significantly over the coming days. So please make sure that you, if you're feeling slightly unwell, isolate yourself, get tested, make sure your vaccinations are taken when they're due. It's critical that every Territorian gets vaccinated, even if it's your first dose. That will still provide protection to you. It will provide protection to your community. It's never too late to take that all-important first dose, and equally for second and third booster doses. So I'll hand to Dr. Payne to provide comment, and then we're both happy to take any questions. Thank you.